I am Nobuko Relnick. I am going to do one Ikebana demonstration. And today I'm using the unusual looking container. This is my friend made this, who's Australian. She went back home already. But this doesn't have any open area. It just has a hole on top of it. So it is very challenging to use this container. So I will do a freestyle, of course. And I have this Catoni oyster from my yard. I think they are ready to take over my yard. They're growing like so tall. Of course, they lost their leaves already, but have a nice, beautiful berries. So I cut some of those a couple days ago. And I'm using red twig dogwood. The volunteer already growing in my yard. And I have about a dozen roses, maybe six roses. And of course, no quinzum. And this will be like this, but I would like to use a little bit sideways, so view will be different. First of all, Catoni oyster is a very straight container. I mean, straight branches. So when I look at the natural material, I try to use it, but not too much hand in it, but trying to show the different outlook when you put it into a container. This has a beautiful berry, and I could bend it. So I bend this a little bit before. If I bend it too hard, it might break. So you have to be very careful. When you do tall ways, it's a good idea to learn how to bend and place it. This time, no kenzan, so I just go straight. And then, show the lines. They should go into another hole, so maybe a circular. This light pops out, so you have to be very careful. There's a berry there starting to drop. It was outside and very cold. I brought inside. So it's quick temperature change. That's what it makes it fall. Oops. I like to create the room between here, space. And problem with the Catoni oyster berries, they don't put the berry on the top, just in the middle way. So this has a middle way, so I don't use a tipper. It's tipper is berry under the inside the container. So it's this one. And this one. I like to do this for the front to show more berries. So when you do Ikebana, every time you do Ikebana with the same material, they always come out differently. So when I give a workshop, same material for 10 people, their arrangement is all different. That's what makes it Ikebana very interesting. And it shows personalities. The Ikebana arrangers show personality. And it's very important to not to use too much technical thing, like putting wire, trying to bend it with using wire. You do not. So I guess you do not to do this. You have the natural branch and your hand to bend it. So I am arranging flowers from behind so you can see the process from front. So I, of course, did practice myself. But when I finish this, you're probably different than from I was doing before. Here is some green dogwood. This green one I just found in my yard, voluntarily growing. And for this dark brown branch, this one I like to show. You can hear my berries dropping all over the table, off the table. I think I have enough red berries, so. Cattonia austra. This is very, very bendable. Dogwood. It's very, very. This is just added a little green color. This is we are into a winter, so it's not many interesting greeneries. I have camellia, rhododendron. And also evergreen. But other than that, I don't find it. Now, I have quite a few holes still open, so I'm going to put some roses. still tight. So if I guess maybe another 2 days, they will open up too much. But the roses, when they open up too much, although I have a funny story, roses could describe the woman's age. Like a little but small, but it's like a baby. And starting to open up, teenagers, and 20 to 30 years old is a prime. So this is about 20 to 30 years. And they open up too much. That's like my age, 80 years old. And then they'll die. So, but roses are, describes the human ages as they grow. So for Ikebana, we like to arrange the roses not fully open. So this is a problem here. We don't have kenzan. So you have to use a little branches around any Ikebana. To show flower to you. If I place this one here, it's going back. So that's to show this for viewer. To the viewer. So flower in a grocery store, I usually go and buy flowers. If I have lots of students, maybe I go wholesale market. And they don't have any varieties of the flowers. It is very unfortunate because Western style arrangement goes for more color. Color is a very important element, but too much color in one arrangement, it is not too much, and it's more like line and space. Okay, let's see. So most of the flower arrangement usually I do is I use drying material in my yard or cataniosa, like a berries, only berries. And I just cut the rowan bay leaf trees, and it smells really nice. It doesn't wilt too fast. So this will be lot of different line combination. It could be mass arrangement with master lines, you could say that also, and also container. So I can touch and cut more, but I think I will stop here. Thank you very much for watching my demonstration.